Hello guys, so today we'll study regarding flammability diagram. So before watching this video, if you have not watched my previous video on inerting and purging, please watch that video and then come to this video, otherwise you won't understand what's happening here. So now let us start with the flammability diagram. Firstly, I will introduce you to the basic things which are there in this diagram. So this is a y-axis, this is the x-axis. So in y-axis it is hydrocarbon gas percentage by volume, and in x-axis it is percentage by volume oxygen. So along with this you have one sloping line which is AB. It is slant, and this is your flammable mixture, and this is lower flammable limit, this is upper flammable limit, and here is the point A, which is pure air. So this represents, this basically diagram is representing the tank's atmosphere. Now let us see how. Now here you see that this is the lower flammable and this is the upper flammable limit. So for all different type of petroleum liquids this will be changing. So in tanker safety guide you will be seeing that there are various MSDS given for many types of petroleum liquids. So in every petroleum liquid the LFL and UFL will be different. So this is, I have taken in general terms, approximately the LFL is approximately 2% by volume and the UFL is approximately 10% by volume. So this is a general, but this LFL and UFL will keep on changing based on different petroleum liquids. So let us start with this. Now let us take a point C, and if you take a point C here and keep, you can see that this is around 20.9% oxygen. So now let us start introducing hydrocarbon gas inside this. So what you will see is the concentration of hydrocarbon will keep on increasing and the oxygen will keep on reducing. So because of this you reach to a point D where it is known as UFL, and similarly it will keep on increasing. So the hydrocarbon will keep on increasing and the oxygen will keep on reducing. So this is one of the reason why our line AB is considered as a slant. As you keep on increasing the hydrocarbon content, the oxygen content will decrease. So this is one of the commonly asked question, why line AB is a slope in flammability diagram, why it is slant. So this is the reason. So the next we have to understand is about the dilution with air and critical dilution with air. So as per me, this flammability diagram, to understand this flammability diagram you have to understand the journey of a cargo tank's atmosphere. So here you see that there is a cargo tank which has a high concentration of hydrocarbon gas, or you can say that it has a mixture of hydrocarbon gas, inert gas and air mixture. Now to gas free this tank, we have to pass through a stage where we have to purge. Why? I will show you the reason why we have to purge. Now let us assume that we take a point F on the flammability diagram. Now as you see, all the points on the left side of AB, they have less oxygen content, okay, and less than 8%. All this will be called as a inert condition, and this F, point F, is a point in a tank's atmosphere which represents the tank atmosphere which is inerted condition. Now to make it gas free, what you will do, if you directly start introducing gas, your flammable your line will pass the flammable mixture. So this is very hazardous in tankers. So for preventing this passing through the flammable mixture, you first reduce the content of oxygen and reduce the hydrocarbon content to prevent combustion. So you will start purging with the help of inert gas, and then you reach a point H, and after reaching point H you can start gas freeing, which will pass through this and which will reach to point A, and the flammable mixture will be prevented. If you start putting your gas, or if you start gas freeing from this point, it will be passing very near to the flammable mixture, which is hazardous again. So that is why this line is called as critical dilution with air, and this is normal dilution with air, which is generally done in all ships. So this is how about flammability diagram. And now let us define what are LFL and UFL. LFL is any hydrocarbon concentration below which there is insufficient hydrocarbon, for combustion. So if the hydrocarbon is less than the point C, then it will not be combustible. Similarly, for UFL, the hydrocarbon, any hydrocarbon concentration above which there is insufficient air, this is the point, above this there is insufficient air for the combustion to occur. So this can be also termed as LEL, that is lower explosive limit, and this can also be termed as UEL, that is upper explosive limit. Both are same. Okay, so this was all about flammability diagram. And whenever you have to draw this diagram, always keep in mind that whenever you draw this diagram, this point E has to be approximately near 11%, and whenever you draw this critical dilution with air, it has to be approximately 4%. So these things you should always take into consideration. And also you should remember that this line which is DE and CE, so if you take a point D and if you take a point C, if you start inerting the atmosphere, it will reach to a common point E, which is approximately 11%. Further, there will be no combustion because the oxygen becomes less than 11, and because of it there will be no combustion. That is why we draw approximately 11%. So this was all about flammability diagram. Thank you guys.